Transhumanza is ancient costume in a sheep herding when in the mid fall shepherd moved the herds from a brutal Apennine mountain to a coastal plain of Apulia, and in the mid spring of each year this migratory pattern was reversed as the herd traveled to the fresher and greener pastures. The word transhumanza comes from the Latin and means moving through the land. Transhumanza is a custom that has its roots in prehistoric time. It developed thanks to trattori, wild grassy pets that even today represent a strong link between man and nature. Transhumanza was a custom also in other parts of Italy, such as the Alpine and Prealpine areas of Valle d'Aosta, Lombardy and Piedmont. In 2019, UNESCO included transhumanza in its list of intangible cultural heritage.
Over the centuries, transhumanza inspired Italian poets and novelists. The most famous one was Gabriele D'Annunzio, an Abruzzese poet and novelist who celebrated our beautiful and green land in this ancient costume in his work I Pastori. This poem belongs to the poem collection Alcione, where he described the autumn arrival when the shepherd moved the herds from Abruzzo mountain to Apulia region.
Settembre. Andiamo. È tempo di migrare. Ora in terra d'Abruzzi i miei pastori lasciano gli stazzi e vanno verso il mare. Scendono all'Adriatico selvaggio, che verde è come i pascoli dei monti. Han bevuto profondamente ai fonti alpestri, che sapor d'acqua natia rimanga nei cuori esuli a conforto, che lungo illuda la lor sete invia. Rinnovato hanno verga d'Avellano. E vanno pel tratturo antico alpiano, quasi per un erbal fiume silente, sulle vestigia degli antichi padri. O voce di colui che primamente conosce il tremolar della marina. Ora lunghesso il litoral cammina la greggia, senza mutamento e l'aria. Il sole in bionda si laviva lana, che quasi dalla sabbia non divaria. Isciacquio, calpestio, dolci rumori. Ah, perché non sono io che i miei pastori.
The most famous tratturi between Abruzzo and Puglia are five: Tratturo Magno, Tratturo Centurale Montesecco, Tratturo Celano Foggia, Tratturo Pescassaroli Candela, Tratturo Castellisangro Lucera. The Tratturo L'Aquila Foggia is the most important of the path of transhumanza. The ship track connects L'Aquila to Foggia and until 50 years ago was used by the shepherd with the change of season and to cover it takes 10 or 11 days. It is the most Adriatic of all. Since it is the only track where ships and shepherds can reach the Adriatic Sea, in particular near Vasto. The beginning can be symbolically located in front of the Basilica of Collemaggio, built in the 13th century with the contribution of the Guild of Lanaioli, or the Association of Wool Workers. The shepherd left for the long journey after obtaining a blessing in front of the basilica.
The Centurale Montesecco is the only one of the five that departs and joins on another tratturo. In fact, it starts directly from L'Aquila Foggia, from the church of Santa Maria di Centurelli, and ends on the same tratturo at the height of Montesecco, in Molise, after having followed a more internal and mountainous path than the Tratturo Magno. The route began in front of the church of Santa Maria delle Centurelle. Churches are only places located along transhumanza paths that provided steady spiritual comfort to the shepherds. Nearby churches and chapels, there were ritual feasts and small fairs during the year and during the periods of transhumanza.
The Celano Foggia is the second longest track in Italy. It passes through the Maiella National Park and the archaeological areas of Vasto Girardi and Pietra Abbondante. Compared to the L'Aquila Foggia ship track, the route crosses areas not yet densely inhabited, such as those between the Maiella National Park and the National Park of Abruzzo, Lazio and Molise, in a long walk through villages, historical sites and nature oases. Its route starts from Celano and reaches Apulia Plains. One of the stops of the Celano Foggia ship track is the sensational Maiella Park. The Maiella National Park is one of the 24 Italian national parks and one of the 3 national parks of Abruzzo, established in 1991 between the provinces of L'Aquila, Pescara and Chieti. Inside there are also 7 state nature reserves and some of the most important cultural assets of Abruzzo. Maiella Massif has recently been designed UNESCO Global Geopark. Other destinations of passage of the Royal Track are the archaeological areas of Vasto Girardi and Pietra Abbondante. The archaeological areas of Vasto Girardi is a Semnite sanctuary in the locality of Sant'Angelo. It's located about a kilometer from Vasto Girardi in the heart of Sannio Pentro. The temple was built between 140-120 BC and still used in the Imperial Age. The Fiater and the Italic Temple of Pietra Abbondante are part of vast archaeological area falling within the municipal territory of Pietra Abbondante in the province of Isernia in the region of Molise. The area is not crossed by any major roads. The sacred area represents for its architectural characteristics and its monumentality the most important archaeological evidence of the culture of the Italian population of the Semnites.
It goes from Abruzzo to Apulia, passing through Molise and Campania, and the width of the track is about 6 meters. It seems the ship track followed the route of the Via Minucia, an ancient Roman road was used by Roman legions to reach Brindisi, which is 2021 km long. Among the 5, Regi Tratturi was the second longest after the Trattura Magno. Its route started from Pescasseroli in the heart of the Abruzzo, Lazio and Molise National Park and reaches the Tavoliere delle Puglie heading at Candela. The shepherd with the sheep, after having traveled hundreds of kilometers, arrived in Tavoliere delle Puglie. The Tavoliere delle Puglie is the second largest plain of the Italian peninsula located in the northern area of the Apulia region.
The Trattura Castel di Sangro Lucera was the shortest of the 5 Regi Tratturi, one of the main sheep tracks in southern Italy. It was one of the routes of transhumance with length of about 130 kilometers. It is interconnected with several tracks such as Celano Foggia and Centurelle Montesecco. The track started from the Taverna della Zittola, a place where the shepherds meet before starting the long journey right on the border between Abruzzo and Molise. From there, they left Abruzzo to proceed towards Tavoliere delle Puglie.
After presenting Transumanza, we would like to introduce you to some of the pastoral tradition typical of your land.
Abruzzo is a land rich in history and traditions, where there are a lot of traditional events of religious origin that still survive, and namely. La Perdonanza Celestiana is a religious and historical event held annually in Aquila on August 28th and 29th. The celebration was instituted by Pope Sales in 1594 with issue of the papal bull Inter Sanctarium Solemnia, also called Bull of Forgiveness, with which he granted plenary indulgence to confess. Worshippers, and during this 2 days, it is kept in Santa Maria di Colemaggio Cathedral. The event, which in 2021 celebrates its 727 edition, is therefore a precursor of the Universal Jubilee of the Catholic Church established by Pope Boniface 1300 and has been accompanied by numerous other civic and historical events that take place throughout the week of August. The anniversary is heritage of Italy for tradition since 2011 and was inscribed in the representative list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity of UNESCO in 2019.
The Feast of the Madonna Who Escapes takes place every Easter Sunday in Sulmona and it celebrates the risen Christ and his meeting with the Madonna. The origin of this event dates back to the Middle Ages, after the service celebrated in the Church of Santa Maria della Tomba. The procession of Brotherhood of Our Lady of Loreto parades through the streets of the city. At the end stands the green banner of the Brotherhood, followed by the brothers with lamplights, the statue of the Risen Christ and of Saint John and Peter. The Statue of Risen Christ is on a canopy that is placed at the entrance of the square. At the other end of the square comes the statue of Madonna dressed in mourning and waiting for the two apostles, John and Peter. The statue of Saint John approaches the statue of the Madonna, symbolizing the announcement of the resurrection of the Son. Mary recognizes the risen Son and suddenly the black mantle and the handkerchief of the Madonna are raised, with a complicated and secret thread mechanism turning into a green dress, embroidered with gold on which stands a red rose. At midday, Madonna begins her run to meet Christ. Tradition wants that if the sequence of the phases of the Madonna's feast that runs away flows without obstacles, the year will be propitious. On the contrary, if something does not work, misfortunes or natural disaster are expected. The worst premonition is in case of fall of the statue of the Madonna during the race.
The Feast of the Serpari takes place in Cocullo on May 1st of each year. It is dedicated to San Domenico Abate. According to a local tradition, the saint, pulling out his tooth and giving it to the population, brought forth a fate that supplanted the pagan cult of the goddess Enginzia, protector of poisons, including that of snakes. The first phase of the festival takes place months before and consists in the search and capture of the snakes, all strictly not poisons. By expert people, locally called the Serpari, who observe the same techniques of their ancestors. The Serparo is the main figure of the rite. At noon begins the procession with the statue of the saint surrounded by snakes placed by Serpari. At the end of the festival, the snakes are released in their natural habitat. It is the custom of the faithful who visit the church of San Domenico in Cocullo to pull with their teeth of the chain of a bell present inside the sanctuary to protect themselves from mouse disease.
The Talami feast takes place in the small village of Orsogna every Tuesday after Easter. Talami are holy representation of the faithful for the Virgin Mary. They are taken in parade in the historical center of this small village and on each Talamo, there are young and adult actors playing scenes from the Old and New Testament. This living biblical painting is placed on a cart carried by tractors. In the 2011, the Festa dei Talami has been appointed Heritage of Italy for Tradition and every year attracts thousands of tourists since this is a show that combines theatre with popular devotion.
It is celebrated on the Sunday before May 23 in Bucchianico. The festival originates from a dispute that there was in the 14th century between Chetini and Bucchianichesi about the borders. The Chetino army was close to the walls and the Bucchianichesi were preparing to repel an attack that was expected fatal for Bucchianico. But Sant'Urbano went into dreams to the sergentiere, the chief of the militia, and suggested that he run the men on the battlements of the walls, in comings and goings, to make the army appear more numerous than it really was. Meanwhile, the rural population had taken refuge, led by Banderese, within the walls of Bucchianico. The trick worked, and the little people stopped attacking. as a reminder of this fact, since then we continue to make the Ciamaichella, which consists in walking in procession the main square with zigzag movements. Flowers in crepey paper of all colors and of all shapes are completed and placed in baskets that are carried on the head by the pacchianelle, from the very small girls to the woman now advanced with the years. The most talented women carry them on their heads without helping themselves with their hands in perfect balance. Instead, men build wagons.
The handicraft traditionally is very strong in Abruzzo, where in the small villages there are still skillful craftsmen that make extraordinary handicraft pieces.
The capital of Abruzzo's handicraft of copper and wrought irons is the small village of Guardiagrele. In wrought irons are mainly produced bed hearths, chandeliers, railings, gates and tool for the government of the fireplace. In copper are produced first all pots and pans, but above all the classic basin, ones used to take the water, and then women were able to keep balancing on their head.
Abruzzo is also famous for its wool, working where there is a big tradition. In the small village of Taranta Perigna, skillful craftswomen still work the careful blanket called Tarante, following the old tradition.
Cardi is the process to allow the wool fibres to be integral and free from turning residues before spinning. Towards the last day of May, shearing the sheep, the wool hung, twisted and gathered in a large sheet.
Then it was dipped in warm water, greased and rinsed well at the river until it became white and put open to the sun to dry well. Once dry, it spread with the hands. The wool was ready to be combed and carded. Carding or combing of wool was done by hand using two pieces of wood, fitted and curved metal tips called scardassi.
Among the most important creation concerning weaving in Abruzzo, it is necessary to mention the beautiful lace tombolo made in Scanno and L'Aquila. The peculiarity of Abruzzo lace is to be worked in a single piece, greatly increasing its value. The tombolo represents the instrument used to work the lace. It's a padded pad placed on a wooden tombolo holder called prepenna. Then we need the wooden stubs, the pins, the thread, and the design of the lace that will be made, generally made on a rigid cardboard. After fixing the drawing of the bobbin, wrap the wire to each pair of bobbins, always in the same direction. Then, won't stop it with the pins and bobbins on the drawing. You can start the work that consists of two movements, turn and cross. With this procedure, it gives place to the points with which you can make light and transparent laces woven of balls, foliage, fruits, flowers, stars, and other various motifs.
A jewel of 18th century origin, a true masterpiece of Abruzzo goldsmith's art, it became famous for the description made by Gabriele D'Annunzio in the Trionfo della Morte. Portava agli orecchi due grevi cerchi d'oro e sul petto la presentosa, una grande stella di filigrana con in mezzo due cuori. Presentosa is a filigree star almost always with one or two hearts in the middle, often tied by a crescent. The gift of the star is a pledge of love and a witness of sacredness. The pendant offered itself as a gift, giving luck to those who wore it with the promise of happiness and love and the security of a prosperous common life. A pledge of man's fidelity to his beloved, then became a symbol of acceptance and hospitality by the acquired family.
Whose long and flexible vegetable stems, called wicker, which are located near the stream and boats, several village of Abruzzo make. Today, as in the past, basket or various other things, which are worked with the same techniques handed down from ancient tradition. A workshop in which wicker is worked is that of Ladro, an abandoned village without ground and immersed in the wide woods of Monte della Laga.
Wood was an easily available material in Abruzzo as a land of mountains and forest. For this reason, during Transumanza stop period, people passed the time engraving the woods. The handicraft of the woods is based mainly on the production of objects, chairs, furniture, the dubotte, that is a sort of a small accordion played still in the village festival, and the cupboards of Arischia, that is a cabinet in which the bread was kept.
From the traditional of breeding instant comes the production of handbag, hats and belt in leather, typical of the province of Teramo, and that saddle and whips which from L'Aquila and exported throughout Europe.
Spaghetti alla chitarra is a first course in the Abruzzo tradition. Their name comes from the instrument used to create them, the guitar. This instrument has metal ropes about 2-3 mm apart, with which you cut the dough, thanks to the pressure of the rolling pin, obtaining in fact elongated wires with a square section. Unlike the classic round spaghetti, the spaghetti made with the guitar has a graver roughness as well as a square section, and this allows to keep more sauce, such as meat or fish sauce, as well as sauces with a strong flavor. The cooking of the spaghetti on the guitar must be absolutely al dente. The pasta is made using durum with semolina, eggs and a pinch of salt. The pasta is processed first by hand to create an elastic consistency. It is then left to rest in the cool and pulled to the rolling pin, keeping a thickness of 2-3 mm. Once the pasta is rolled, strips called patelle are created that are placed on the guitar and transformed into spaghetti thanks to the press of the rolling pin.
Saffron is a spice that is obtained from the stigmas of the flower of the Crocus sativus, also known as a real saffron. The stem and stigmas are collected and dried to be used mainly in cooking, as a condiment and diet. The spice is sold a powder contained in sachets and or jars with the whole filaments inside. The saffron of Novalis is considered for its quality and value the best in the world, and for its renowned excellence is called the red gold of Novalis. The birds sown in the L'Aquila plateau immediately found ideal climate and soil and came out a product far superior to the cultivated in other nations.
The soup with cardiale abruzzese is a typical dish of the region Abruzzo really complete. The good soup with meatballs, cheese, eggs and especially the thistle delicate flavor makes this dish a unique specialty. It is a recipe that every Christmas and a Santo Stefano cannot miss on the tables of Abruzzo. The preparation laborious. The thistles, rather bit from raw, should be cleaned well and boiled for a long time. A good soup requires at least a couple of hours of cooking. Tradition would like a nice old chicken soup, and patience is also needed to prepare meatballs. A delicious soup with a strong flavor.
It is the typical dish of Abruzzo, or rather it would be better to say Teramo. The area of origin is located between the Fino and the Tronto. On May 1st, the custom also widespread in other areas of the sud to celebrate the gods to propitiate the fertility of the land and the abundance of the summer harvest. It is a very rich soup where we find the first seasonal vegetables and the cleaning of the cupboard that his wife made 30 April, considered a watershed that between the end of the rigors of winter now ended and the arrivals of the most fertile spring.
Rossicini are born on the eastern side of Mount Voltigno in the chain of the Gran Sasso, but today they are produced practically everywhere in the territory of Abruzzo. The origins date back to several hundred years ago, when the shepherds moved to the highlands for transhumance. The myth was cut into cubes and placed on small skewers that were obtained from the stem of aquatic plants collected along the rivers. According to the original recipe, during the preparation of the skua, which must reach a maximum length of 40 centimeters, it is important to mix lean meat pieces with fat meat pieces. So when they are cooked on barbecue, the smell and taste are extremely delicious.
Abruzzo has also an excellent production of cheese. Pecorino is the cheese we produce in this area. It is a strong test cheese that can be found in a wide range of varieties.
Let's find out what are two excellent types. Pecorino di Farindola, the main feature of this cheese, is that it is produced using pig rennet. This gives the cheese a unique taste. This cheese is a harmony between spicy nuances and intensity of milk.
Pecorino Marchetto tests its predictable cheese of very ancient origin. Its characteristic is to have a maturation during which it is fundamental to support the work of the larvae of flies that lay their eggs between the cracks of the crust. It is precisely this peculiarity that builds its strong personality told by the very intense flavor and particularly spicy tones.
The Caciocavallo Abruzzese is a cheese with spun pasta now widespread throughout the Abruzzo region, traditionally produced in the areas of the province of L'Aquila. Its name comes from the custom of tying two sheep to a thread of raffia and hanging them on horns of a stick for aging that can last from 3 months to 2 years. Caciocavallo is mainly found in the areas of the province of L'Aquila, but there are also productions in the rest of the protected territory. It can be found on the market all year round, considering that the minimum ripening time can be 60-70 days, and in this case the cheese is fresher and softer, with sweet aromatic notes. While with a longer maturation, the Caciocavallo will have spicy notes and a greater consistency.
The Parrozzo is a typical Abruzzo sweet of Pescara origin. It is a typical Christmas time cake, very widespread, especially in the eastern area of Abruzzo. It has obtained the recognition of traditional agri-food products of the Abruzzo region. The Parrozzo was conceived and prepared in 1920 by Luigi D'Amico, owner of a pastry shop in Pescara. D'Amico had the idea of making a cake with the appearance of a rustic bread, also called Panrozzo, which was a semi-spherical loaf that was prepared by the farmers with corn and intended to be preserved for many days. The first person to whom Luigi D'Amico had the Parrozzo tasted was Gabriele D'Annunzio. The Parrozzo is made with yellow flour, sugar, chopped almonds, bitter almond essence, orange peel, and is covered with dark chocolate.
È tanto buono sto parrozzo nuovo che pare una piazza di Santa Città. Ci avesse messo il suo grano forte della terra lavorata dalle bove, la terra grassa e lustre che si cuoce e che diventa a poco più dolce di qualunque cosa d'oggi.
There are various types of sugar at El Monte Simonesi confetti, the most characteristic of which are formed by bunches of colorful flowers, or daisies or poppies. In addition, each candy of each bucket has various types of taste, from chocolate to caramel, from apple to orange. These candies are used in Italy for special occasions such as white, used for wedding, pink, birth and first wedding anniversary, celestial, baptism and first communion, red, the Greek celebration, green, wedding of bronze.
They are a typical dessert of Lanciano, are filled with scrocchiette, that is grape jam, after sometimes some chocolate is added as a variant. They are very similar to stuffed baskets and are among the most beloved sweets in this city. A typical Easter cake with fresh cheese. The popular tradition wants to make them close as an envelope. For this reason, they're called love letters.
Liquore di genziana. The recipe of the gentian liquor has a strong link with the history of Abruzzo and with some distinctive aspects of the local tradition. Many testimonies from the past say that the first recipes of gentian liquor date back to the period of transhumance, arrived in the mountain eras. The shepherds gathered the roots of gentian, a plant that is found only in these areas, and used them for its beneficial properties, such as fighting fever or curing the cold, or the most appreciated property even today, an excellent digestive. Precisely from this benefit, the idea arose of obtaining a distillate by taking a small amount after meals.
Was born in 1817 in Tocco da Casaria by the skillhead of Beniamino Toro and the 100 herbs from which is distilled. Unmistakable green liquor are collected at the foot of Maiella Madre and Mound Morrone, used to treat in the cholera epidemic in the Kingdom of Naples. The Centarba still today plays the podium among the spirits with the highest alcohol content on Italian market.
Is a liquor spread throughout the region based on black cherry and red wine made from grapes of the Montepulciano grape variety. It is traditionally produced by placing in a varying proposition according to the local recipe, whole unpitted ripe sour cherries and sugar in glass containers exposed to the sun for about 30 days in order to favor fermentation. The red wine is then added to the product, leaving in to macerate and stirring periodically for at least another 30 days, but it can also be up to 5-6 months. The product is then filtered and bottled. In some cases, after filtration, alcohol is added to increase the alcohol content.
Montepulciano d'Abruzzo is a typical grape of the central Italy, in particular of the regions overlooking the Adriatic. The characteristics of Montepulciano wine are unmistakable. The color is ruby red with purple reflection. The nose note of berries and spice, while the palate express olive depth. Montepulciano wine is a DOC country designation orange Abruzzo wine. Trebbiano d'Abruzzo is one of the most famous wheat wines of central Southern Italy and is produced in the province of Chieti, Pescara, L'Aquila and Teramo. It is particularly appreciated of the simplicity and exquisite flesh, so as to be a perfect company, the combo with fish menus. Ceratolo d'Abruzzo is a rose wine produced with the Montepulciano grape variety. Ceratolo d'Abruzzo is characterized by its
cherry pink color. It is a fresh rose wine with a ring ICDC and good alcohol content. Montepulciano, the base grape variety from the products of the Cerasuolo d'Abruzzo DOC, is characterized by the presence of Enzionics, make it one of the longest live rose wines in Italy. The nose elegant aromas on fresh red fruit. It has a pleasing fresh taste with a good aromatic persistence. It goes well with fish soup, grilled fish, roasted wheat, meats, and medium Asian cheese.
The traditional Abruzzese wedding dress has a veil or long white tiered tissue, on head down to shoulder, red silk bodice with long sleeves and cuffs fastened with golden buttons. The white skirt, the blue apron in flex or out of textile fabric, black leather shoes and white stockings. Men costumes are simpler, made of cloth or black velvet, with trousers to the knee, white socks, shirt jacket with or without buttons, waistcoat and shirt with embroidered collar. At the feet, the choche, whose laces are tied around the calves, covered in thick white wool stockings.
This typical Abruzzo female custom of Abruzzo is made of white skirt, bodice and a fluffy shirt. On the black or red skirt, there is a white linen apron. The bodice is usually in black velvet. Under the bodice, you wear a white shirt with a head embroidered lace, while covering the head a large white tissue.
The costume features rich seals in the sleeve and in the harness, which are embroidered in gold thread. The apron belt, green as the hem, passes begin and not in a front falling on the red.
The headdress is formed by a wool cloth on the various color squares, shaped that fall transversely is wrapped around the end and L, by a knot made behind the neck so that left too tall fall on your shoulders. Under this headdress, there is another cloth on color white, triangular shape, that is wrapped and clothed around the head. The dark green skirt is a heavy cloth fabric and has several folds. It is joined by a piece of cloth. It is long up to the ankle. Around the skirt there is a dark red cloth footboard.
It's one of the most elegant costumes in Abruzzo, clearly inspired by French model with puff skirt.
It is a legendary figure of courage and ferocity, on the chest door always a crucified. Brigand or soldier loyalist do not know. The costume repeats, however, the model Albanian community from Tirana.
The bagpipe is the bagpipe player. One musical instrument consists of a flask which acts as an air reservoir as well to allow the musician to catch your breath without interrupting the sound. The bagpipe was the shepherd who playing the traveled inside himself, and in it was lost. It was a contemplator of stars, of Trogd, a piper of the transmans. In fact, the bagpipe was used to call the flock to order. It has a regional costume equal everywhere with stuffed sheep, cone hat and knee length.
The quadrille is traditional Italian dance spread on Trogut, the national territory, particularly in the center-sud. Dancers generally put themselves in a two rows, arranged in front of each other or otherwise arranged in square, from which the name of the ball would seem to derive, in group of 2 to 5 dancers. The quadrille subdivided in 5 phases, the figure that the choreographer decide the way to arrange. Even the music that accompanies is called quadrille, which is generally in equal time and predominantly played with folk instruments, usually accordion or diatonic organ. Couples perform figures, also complex, which are proposed by the couple who leads and is followed by all that follow.
According to same scholars, the name Tarantella comes from Taranta, the dialectal term of the southern region Italian to designate the tarantula, a poisonous spider widespread in southern Europe. In those areas, the dance of Tarantella is partly related to the bite therapy tarantula. The person who was bitten or believed to have been bitten by a tarantula tend to exaggerate to dynamics and resort to choreomusical therapies, particularly effective during the feast of St. Peter and Paul. Not all forms of dance were still linked to this phenomenon. Dancing also on public occasions, religious festivities, pilgrimage to shrines, celebration agricultural, and private weddings, expressions of religiosity and joy. Saltarella is a traditional dance of Abruzzo area, part of Molise. The most common form is a saltarella in pair, but they are also a preserved example of jumping to four people or in a circle. It's a courtship dance in which couples sit in a circle and in turn they take to stand to perform the ritual of seduction. When are within the circle, the two lovers trying to maintain a certain synchrony in the movements do not touch but touch each other with continuous allusions. In the couple dance, after usual invitation, the dancers try to synchronize in music time and then make skipped cross-shoulder steps, always placing in one foot behind the other that is made the crawl forward before receiving the whole body weight. The peak can also be simply jumped and the foot, unloaded from its mate, is kicked energetically forward and be joined again to the other that repeats the sequence. The arms are stretched up frontally, composed on the hip or behind the back for men. The dancing couple can be grasped frontally with the hands looking into the eyes. The whole concluded when the two dancers holding in other arms perform with lateral steps a circular part extended until their exit from the scene.
He ties front ties to the quadril and is dancing presently on music for quadril during the days of carnival. Couples dance in a circle around a pole on which are tied colored ribbons. You dance to the command of a master or master of dance, which imparts the orders. Each dancer holds a ribbon. It is the man who, in the initial phase and on command of the master, they go to take two ribbons or laces and bring one to their dance partners. From here, the master give a series of commands and bring the pace to perform a series of evolution and figure around the pole, in time with the ribbons in a suggestive and spectacular way. Once that, the ribbons will wrap and braided along the pole. They must be dissolved by executing, always under command, the same evolution but in the opposite sense. If the order of the master are dictated and executed correctly, at the end of the dance, all the tables will be dissolved and the couples will find themselves in their position of departure.
It's a very old and widespread dance. The dance takes its name from continuous exchange of rhythmic blows. The data commands are allusive and provocative, with particular reference to the sexual sphere.
The Vola Vola is the most famous Abruzzo folk song, but is also a widespread dance. The commands given are allusive and provocative with particular reference to the sexual sphere. This agrees with the fact that even today this dance seems to be tied especially at wedding rituals.
The original piece by anonymous author, arrived in Abruzzo with the Slavic refugees and then entered the Abruzzese tradition, it was called Addi Addi Amore, also known as Nebila Valle, and seems to come from the Maiella Area Oriental. The dam of singing is that the abandonment of land by entire generation of men and women to seek fortune overseas, and was sung by harvesters of Abruzzo olives.